Tonight, an exclusive look at how the state and Plaquemines Parish are rebuilding a critical barrier island. I-Team reporter Richard Angelico continues his look at the battle to save the vanishing Louisiana coastline.
Where we are right now was water just a week ago.
What you are seeing is a marvel of modern engineering. Hundreds of thousands of cubic yards of silt and sand being harvested from the Gulf to rebuild a hurricane-ravaged barrier island. It once protected Bajo Wise and all of Southwest Plaquemines Parish.
As you pump it, what happens is the silt tends to wash away and it just leaves the sand.
It is the same principle as panning for gold. The lighter material washes away while the heavier grains of sand remain. It seems impossible that bulldozers weighing tons can work in this wet sand without sinking.
This is pretty good material here that we can work dozers out in front of the field like this.
The sand is delivered through a long snaking pipeline, which begins 9 miles away at the Dredge, Alaska. The dredge sucks sand from the bottom of the Gulf, then two pumps generating almost 15,000 horsepower send it coursing toward the island at Bajo Wise. Every day as the island grows in length, new pipe is added to the line. So far, more than 3,500 feet of island have been constructed, 9,000 more to go. While bulldozers push and compact the sand, backhoes construct a dam on the backside of the island where marsh material would be deposited and grasses planted. It is man helping Mother Nature heal her self-inflicted wounds.
I don't know if we help Mother Nature restore it because we're doing the restoration and she seems to be constantly knocking them down. So I'm not for sure, but it is putting it back like it was at some time in history.
Just 2 months ago, this is how the island looked. A tiny spit of land sticking up out of the Gulf, a small resting place for birds and an occasional human or two. Hurricanes and tidal surges had virtually destroyed it, leaving only a foundation beneath the waves. But worse, with no protection from the island, tens of thousands of acres of marshland behind it also vanished, falling victim to saltwater intrusion. What was once lush marshland capable of reducing tidal surge is now open water, a superhighway for hurricane-driven water into Southwest Plaquemines. When the island is completed, it will have a 300-foot-wide beach built 4 feet above sea level. In the island's center, a 100-foot-wide dune raised 2 feet higher. And behind it, a strip of newly created marsh to help hold it in place.
We're building the beach here. We're pumping marsh material behind here to create marsh. And this marsh will help support the beach to protect it. And together, the two of them protect the marsh that's between here and New Orleans, which helps us provide for hurricane protection and also for nurseries for the fisheries and that sort of thing.
This is huge, Richard, because this is something that we've wanted to do for a long time.
P.J. Hahn is director of coastal zone management in Plaquemines Parish. He says we need to worry about hurricanes not just during the season, but 365 days a year.
We got to keep these dredges moving down here in South Louisiana. It's critical to us. It's critical to all the surrounding parishes. What we do in Plaquemines Parish is going to have a dramatic effect on the other parishes above us.
On your side, Richard Angelico, WDSU, News Channel 6.
The restored island will be about 2.5 miles. It will cost about $30 million.